Hi guys, so Olivia here and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to talk through six exercises, stretches that I do after my running. I admit now I don't do all these stretches after every run I do because I don't. I'm going to be honest with you guys. I tend to pick and choose the stretches that I feel appropriate for the workout for the run I have just done. For instance, at the moment, because of my injury, I'm doing my rear foot elevated hip flexor stretch, my calf stretch, and my tibialis anterior muscle stretch at the moment for my injury. And then, for instance, if I were to do a hill rep session after that, I would look at doing kind of my quad stretch and my hip flexor stretch and my calf stretch because those are the muscles I kind of use to power myself up those hills. And then I might think, oh, I haven't done any glute stretches this week or my adductor stretch this week. So I tend to bring those in as well towards the end of the week if I feel I'm lacking some as well. So the six stretches I'm going to go through are my rear elevated hip flexor stretch, my calf stretch, my tibialis anterior stretch, and my quad stretch, and my adductor stretch, and my glute stretch. And also at the end of the video, there's going to be a bonus stretch that is just really nice, really relaxing, and something to do at the end of the run. And of a workout or after you've had a shower, just really nice to do this exercise at the end. So watch the video to get to the exercise at the end. So this is going to be the rear elevated hip flexor stretch. So I'm using on a chair, as we all have chairs, but you can also use the edge of the sofa or a workout bench if you have it or doing it in after the gym. So basically, you need to put I have a cushion here to protect my knees, but if you're comfortable with your knee on the floor, then you don't need the cushion. But this is just nice to protect the knee joint if you have sensitive knees. So, what you need to do is foot on top of the chair or your sofa, knee on the cushion. Bring the other leg forward like so. So, as you can see, my hip flexors are quite tight. And so my hip is already quite forward. So you want to stand tall to engage your core muscles. Then engage your bottom, so squeeze your glute muscles and come forward, working that hip flexor stretch. Come back, squeeze, and come forward. Up you come, squeeze, and come forward, stretching that hip flexor muscle at the front of the hip. So, with this stretch, with most stretches, the kind of scientific evidence out there is that you should do hold between 15 to 30 seconds and do between 2 and 4 sets. With this one, I like to do about 20 seconds per leg, 3 times. So the squeeze and push and relax. Go with your breath and do that for 20 seconds one leg, 20 seconds the other leg, and do that 3 times per leg. So, stretch number two is the calf stretch. There are many variations around with the calf stretch, but this is one I like to do. It's using the wall and standing upright. Some people prefer to do a calf stretch with a standing on a step and drop the heels back, but I just feel this is more beneficial to me. So let's have a look. So find yourself a wall and stagger your feet. So we're going to work this back calf. So both toes should be pointing forwards towards the wall. Then adjust to feel a stretch in your back leg. Imagine you're pushing the heel through the floor, and also you're leaning into that wall to feel a really nice stretch. Engage your core just to hold you upright and keep your core and back safe and stable. And we're going to hold for 30 seconds and then we'll swap over legs and then we'll repeat. So on the other leg, same idea, pushing that heel through, bending that front knee and pushing against the wall. Now, if you, that's going to work your long calf muscle, your gastroc, but to work your smaller calf muscle, your soleus, all you can do is bend that knee and you're working your soleus. And again, hold this for 30 seconds, twice on each leg. So that's the calf. Hi guys, so we've come down lower for the next three stretches. So the next stretch is the quad stretch. You can do the standing up by just bending your knee and taking your foot in your hand and taking it behind the body. I just prefer lying down because after most runs, lying down is what exactly what we want to do, and I just feel it gives me a more beneficial stretch. So let's go through it. So lie down, make yourself feel comfortable. So just take that leg and bring it into the body. So you're aiming to take your foot towards your bottom. You can hold it here for again 30 seconds per leg, twice through, or you can, to give you a deeper stretch, lift the knee slightly and push that foot into the hand and hold. Feel a nice stretch on the front of the quad and relax and go again. Now, if you're doing this active stretch by lifting your knee and pushing your foot towards your hand, then aim to do that 20 seconds and then three times per leg. And plus, doing this lying down, it gives you a good idea about how your quad is feeling and functioning, because the closer you can get it to your bum, the better. Hi, so the next exercise is the stretch for your tibialis anterior muscle. I'm doing this, your tibialis anterior muscle runs down the front of your shin here, and it's often a muscle that's involved in medial tibial stress syndrome, or commonly known as shin splints. And for me, it's the exercise I'm doing at the moment because I have overworked my tibialis anterior muscle and it's a bit inflamed. And basically, all you're going to do is sit on your heels. If you struggle to keep your heels together, then grab a friend to help you. So let's have a look. So, heels together and sit back. And just sit and feel the stretch along the front of your shin. Again, hold this for 30 seconds. And because we're doing both legs together, do it to two to three times. If you need to readjust by squeezing your ankles together, and do so, adductor stretch. So these are the muscles of the inner thighs. Now I'm using a mat, but if you don't have a mat, then use a towel. It's just much safer on your knees, especially if you're not wearing long tights like I am. So we're going to do an active adductor stretch. So we're going to squeeze, hold, and release to really work these inner thighs, a muscle that does get restricted through running, and it's just good to open up these hips and get them working fully. So let's talk you through it. So, on the mat, knees apart, and we're going to take it so we're nice and comfortable. Let me lean move forward. As you can see, if I move along, as you can see, my knees and ankles are at 90 degrees on the floor. Now you can play around with the stretch to feel where you feel it. So you can lean back and you can take it forwards. So play around with the stretch and work out how it feels for you. So, nice and simple, you're going to squeeze those knees together, squeeze, hold, and then relax. Take those knees wider. Squeeze, hold for about 10, and then relax out and take them wider. Squeeze, hold, and relax. And you can do it moving backwards, and you do it moving forwards. So that's the adductor stretch. So this next stretch is the glute piriformis stretch, to stretch out your glute muscles, so in your bottom. And it's just really nice because we need to loosen up those glutes, especially for us runners. So I'm using a mat. If you don't have a mat, then use a towel. It's just a bit more comfortable than lying on the floor. So first of all, lie back, bend your knees. Then you can put one foot on the other knee and wrap your hands round and bring that foot back, bring that knee towards your chest like so. And also subconsciously try and push that knee out. So let me swap sides. So come subconsciously try and push that knee out. And hold. Let me swap over legs so you can see what it looks like on both legs. So bring it forward, but at the same time, try and push that opposing knee out. Going to feel a good stretch on your bottom of the leg that's the foot is on the knee. So again, we want to hold for 30 seconds each leg twice through. So, lastly, the bonus exercise is an exercise that is just glorious. And it's just really nice to hold this stretch after a run, after you do stretches, or any time during the day. It's just really nice. So, we're going to put the legs against the wall. The aim is to get your bottom as close to the wall as possible and legs against the wall in the air. Just bringing that blood back to the body, and it also is great for relaxing the legs. Hold this stretch for like 60 seconds or as long as you like, and you can even lay in this position and read a book, read a magazine, watch TV, whatever you fancy. So let's get into it. So, bum against the wall. And just relax. Glorious stretch. And you can read a book here, I can watch TV and play around with it. So you might want your legs straight, or might want to stretch out the inner thighs a little bit. That's all it is to it. Simple. So those were my mix and match stretches that I do on a regular basis. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, share, and subscribe to my channel for more videos. And of course, whatever you do, hashtag killing it.